Welcome. Hello. How are you doing? Today we are at Om Bookshop in DLF Place, and we've gathered with a bunch of authors here to discuss books, books and books. We have with us today Piyusha. Piyusha is a short story author, has contributed to multiple anthologies, and has recently launched her solo book of short stories, Just Another Day, available on Kindle, which is getting rave reviews by the way. With Piyusha, we have Aashisha. We'll have to catch later on. So we have Aashisha. Aashisha has recently joined Airtel. She finished her MBA and has joined Airtel. So congratulations on that. She's also a very, very renowned short story author and has contributed to multiple anthologies and recently won TOI Write India contest under
Shobha Day.
So imagine, that's a big one. Okay. So yeah, now and we have Anupama Jain.
Hi. You know,
she has actually expanded a short story of 200 words into a full-scale novel of 80,000 words. And that's going to be released next month. Can you imagine? 200 to 80,000.
Yeah.
There's a backstory to it. We'll discuss that later on. But coming back to books and stories. So Piyusha, starting with you.
Yeah.
Tell us the history of Just Another Day. How did you come out writing it and what was it about?
It's a collection of three short stories which span over the duration of a day. And how it came about was exactly how it is in the title. It just happened over a day. It's just another day for me, and when the day
ended... You're not lying, right?
No, I'm not. I'm actually being very honest about it. Brutally honest, in fact.
Watch your nose.
No, it's not growing longer. So that's how it happened. And when the day ended, somebody gave me a go-ahead on those stories, and we were good to go with the book.
Were they all three, or did you pick up from a lot of multiple stories and then pick up the best three?
I tried to pass off some previously written stories, but the editor was very quick to figure that out, and she made me write fresh. But once I had written three fresh stories and sent them across, they were approved in one go.
Nice. You both have written this book, read this book, right?
Yeah. Yes.
So, what was your feedback about the book?
My personal favorite is, I mean, I have seen her write for a long time, and my personal favorite is that elevator story. It actually elevates you. It's a very funny story, and what happens is till you read the last line, you don't know what she's talking about, and then once you read that, you keep going back, you know.
And you know she's biased on elevators, by the way, because her novel starts on an elevator as well. So the 200 word story actually is an elevator story as well. So you were biased, we know that.
The whole story happened, the 200 word story happened in an elevator.
Absolutely.
And that's it.
And that got us an idea.
Yeah, it is a lifting story, I hope.
Yeah, it's interesting, you know. It's a story of how Paula became Padma and Padma became Paula, and you know.
Paula is Padma Lakshmi actually. Yeah. So she goes through a city, she becomes a hep girl and she calls herself Paula now.
Yeah, so are you Padma or are you Paula?
I am Paula, exterior Padma. Always.
Nice. Good. Interesting. So Aashisha, have you read about the book?
So I think the best thing I liked about her short stories was that the span in which she wrote, you know, over a day. So a lot can happen in a day, and I like the way she sort of timed it. And then there's been a change in the way her first story was, I think, published in Mock Stopping Quarter, like mine. So I had read it then, and I had realized that she has a thing, a certain writing style that had changed in this one, which had a touch of humor. And
she's
really
dealt with
that.
All the emotions here.
Yeah.
I mean, there's one somber story, there is one very
suspense,
sad story, and the last one, you know, kind of brings the zing.
Mm-hmm.
So it was so nice to see that, you know, ekdam difference in the way she has brought
grown
up,
as a writer.
Grown, yeah,
she's
exactly.
Grown as a short story writer. With every story, it's sort of, you know, graduating.
You have to flaunt that smile. You had the right to do that, you know.
But was it tough writing these stories? Because you've always wanted to publish your first novel, and you were hell-bent on taking that forward, and then your publisher pushed you in doing short stories. Did that work out for you? Do you feel more confident? Do you think it was the right thing to do?
I think yes, because I think that's why this particular book happened, because I was too stuck on that novel. And it's good that I actually set that aside and moved on with other writing and other short stories and just growing as a writer, because had I been stuck on that, I would still have been probably struggling how to get that book out, and it's good to have not published it so soon. I'm glad.
Given a chance, I think short stories have a lot more interesting verb to them because you can explore across.
I think short stories have always had a good audience, especially when O. Henry's short stories used to be a rage.
Classic.
And from there, you know, you got these ideas. Even Ruskin Bond started with them, the children's tales, and even those night poems or something. I really love them. I don't know why it's not exactly. I don't know if it's a rage these days or not.
I think it's coming back now.
Yeah,
it probably lost its interest in between, but it's coming back now. Major.
By the way, guys, don't be surprised if you see Aashisha becoming the spokesperson of a national political party in a few years. She is the right person to be politically correct all the time, and
right
has got the
right
taste and left. And middle and all directions and all sides of the center. Okay, no controversy on that. But yeah, so I'm sure you must have observed that thing.
I just got a new career path.
Excellent.
Short story writer, speaker.
Look at the words she used, you know, the thing and all the literally correct words that she used for Aashisha.
We are taught that in MBA. That is what we do. Just say the right thing.
Use the words.
Yeah,
use
absolutely.
The right.
So, Piyusha, so tell us something more about how was this journey of the last 1 month that the book has been published?
Full of surprises, full of humbling moments, counting my blessings all the time, and each day was just another day because I would wake up and think now nobody's reading the book, and suddenly there would be 5 reviews or 10 reviews or at least a couple of messages every day. So when the day ended, it was completely different from how it had started. So very rewarding, yes.
Good. Aashisha, which was your first story that got published in an anthology? The Defiant Dreams?
Yes. It was a 3 short story contest, and it was my story was about that woman who actually did mechanical engineering, and then when she went into a company, she did not she was not given that kind of importance or that kind of a job. So that is what it revolved around.
Very interesting.
Yeah, so it was, the name was Please Leave Your Sex Outside. That the one in Defiant Dreams, and Vidomania had given that break. So glad.
And you've written a lot of short stories after that. How many books did you get under your name after that?
I think Twilight's Children
all
is
the anthologies.
Almost all.
Yeah. This one was this one is the fourth one. Twilight's Children. The first one was Defiant Dreams. Then Mock Stock and Quadrant. Okay, the first one was Kafiana,
yes.
Interesting.
So, I'll come to that as well. So, let me introduce you to the person behind the camera as well.
Hello,
hi.
People.
That's Saumya. And Saumya doesn't need an introduction right now. Does she? She's already a celebrity of sorts. You've seen her in all the festivals. You've seen moderating sessions all across, everywhere. And she hides her face. Yeah.
Let's get to the point, Dipankar.
Yes.
What do you want me to talk about?
The point is that, you know, the book she mentioned, Kafiana, was a collection of poetry in which Saumya was also there.
Right.
Her poem was also there. So that's where she began her work with Vidomania as well. And ever since... Yeah, that's an interesting connection.
Yeah.
I didn't remember that and they remember that. So that's wonderful.
Books live longer than our imagination and thoughts and memories.
Absolutely.
But if I might just come in, you know, they were discussing about this entire genre of short story writing. And I honestly believe Dipankar, Piyusha, Anupama and Aashisha, it's more relevant now than ever. Because when are we reading? We're reading on commutes, we're reading in shorter durations, we're reading in bits and pieces in coffee shops.
Absolutely.
And novels, I'll tell you personally, they don't hold my interest for that longer because I keep losing the plot. I would rather prefer to read one poem, which just finishes, you know, within that while. Or I would prefer to just read a short story which begins and ends right then and there. And I'm completely not surprised that Piyusha's book is getting such rave reviews. Because, you know, that's what we need as readers of the time. We might all be great writers in the making, but we all began as readers, as passionately associated with literature. So I think this is a great time for short stories.
Wonderful. Absolutely. We'll come to you. We'll definitely come to you. And the camera goes back to you. And, you know, interestingly, short stories also are a good way to test waters. Each one of you get to develop a readership who's loyal to you. And you figure out that, am I writing good enough to be published, you know, or am I writing like any other person? And we all know, India is a land of writers.
Yeah, I actually agree with that.
And not a land of readers. We have more writers than readers.
But I actually agree with your point because just another day, publishing that book gave me the confidence that it's good enough to actually be out there, because otherwise you keep having this doubt whether the stories that you're writing are worth it, worth the reader's time and money or not. And when this book was out, it actually gave me that confidence. So I completely agree with his point on that, yes.
And there used to be a time when I remember Charles Dickens used to put out his, you know, one chapter in a serialized form, and that is how he actually gained his readership. So short stories are actually a way to do that. And once you're confident that your plot lining, your layering is good, then I think you finally, you can, as he said, test the waters and understand whether you can actually do a full-length novel, if it's actually worth it.
I started with what is called a two-line tale. I used to write, you know, for a long time, the entire story in two lines, two sentences. Then came that 300-word story. Then, yeah. My God, odd even
chronicles we pondered over that.
No, I think Chronicles was way before all that. Chronicles.
I've seen Chronicles and
Frost
and Water, the books that you missed out so many.
Multiple. But I didn't know about the previous two. Yeah.
Hey, she's, you know, and she's grilled me. She was gonna be one of the first publishers who grilled a, sorry, author who grilled a publisher.
I think that's written on my grave. It'll be written on my grave also. We'll
discuss that probably your own unknown. But as of now, let's get back to this. So thank you very much, guys. I think we'll just take closing comments from all of you and get this going. So Anupama.
I enjoyed reading that.
That was a closing action, not a comment.
So it's like the Metro.
You're being politically incorrect now.
Why?
Yeah, yeah.
Mitra is the bad word of the season.
No,
not at all. Anyway, it's a dear friend, Piyusha, and the moment it came out, I bought it and I read it, and I was giggling over the stories. I was feeling sad with the story. It was wonderfully written, and it's absolutely, you have to feel extremely proud of your page.
Thank you.
I think I'll just say one line, short and sweet. So your stories were like, you take a tea break and you read one story and then, so this
go
is how,
work.
Yeah. So that was a respite for me. So it was really awesome. Okay. Keep going.
Thank you. I will only say one thing. Thank you so much for all the love that the book has received so far. Please continue giving the love. If you've read the book, review it. If you've reviewed it, recommend it. So the 3 R's which every author would,
recommend it?
Read, review, and recommend. The three R's for the author.
Okay guys, thank you so much for joining us. Bye bye, have a nice day.
Thank you.